Okay, so we have a pretty fleshed out version here that we could demonstrate with some flow with our clickable demo. It's a good time once again to do a design critique with your team. Just go over these screens, make sure you're not missing anything. And you know, when you're ready, you might start to think about if this needs to be polished for a client presentation. So let's look at how to switch from our sketchy skin to a wireframe skin. Now we're going to just switch over to the project information panel with this icon here. We could also use Control or Command Comma, and then select the wireframe button. And we're going to also select a different font, Helvetica for now. You'll notice that the sketchy lines now have become either block shapes or rectilinear lines. All our text blocks from earlier are now these gray boxes. And I'm going to swap these all using transform to real text. And I'm going to just start filling in some text from our customer. So this is going to be the ordering information. And we have the specials on the right. And there's some, the text control has some special macros to do things like change sizes and add colors. And I'm using these brackets here to indicate links for some of these menu items. And once you do that, you'll notice that the inspector shows that you can actually link some of these items. So I'm going to link the Chuck Norris chicken to the tacos page. All right, so we're on the tacos page. And now you can see that a lot of the shapes have been kind of change to these really thinner lines and a little bit more rectilinear borders. And just gonna go through and, you know, make some minor tweaks to, you know, font sizes where I need to adjust the alignment, because, you know, in our earlier exercise of just kind of sketching this out, we were just dropping controls into the screen without really thinking too hard about alignment or, you know, placement of stuff. We were just using the alignment guides to just like put things close to each other. So I'm now just kind of nudging things into place and making it a little bit more presentable if I needed it to be shown to a client, for instance. And if you're doing a usability test, you might want to do this as well. So I'm just selecting a bunch of controls here. I'm using the alignment controls to center them. And let's see, I'm going to go to the symbol, make sure this is centered in the viewport, and, you know, nudge the buttons and icons a little bit. So that should look better. I'm going to just align some of my buttons a little better. So there's not really much you need to do here. Once you switch to the wireframe skin, it's just a matter of tidying things up. I'm changing the panel size here just to be a little tighter. So it's looking decent. I think this is not bad. You know, you'll always find something that you need to, that you might want to clean up if you're really kind of concerned about who the audience is for this. For the most part, we're not really concerned about making things look too polished here. We're not in the business of making wireframes. We're just really more getting the ideas figured out. So, you know, there's a couple more aesthetic changes here. I'm just going to change the panels to be this pale gray color. Okay, so maybe one of the last things you think about doing is adding some annotations. So the UI library has a markup category, and there's a callout that you could add. So all these are little indicators of sections of your wireframe, and I added a bunch of these and numbered them. And, you know, I just went to the notes and added notes to identify what each of these parts of the UI are. And there's a little toggle in the toolbar to hide and show these. So if you're demonstrating this, you don't necessarily need to show the notes. But in like in full screen view here, you can also just, you know, you'll see the notes in the inspector panel. And with the settings, you can turn all those annotation callouts on and off. Or you can also use the M key to toggle them. And then your prototype view will just kind of let you demonstrate, and then, you know, use callouts as you go if you need to point something out. Okay, so there's not much to making changes in the wireframe skin. It's just about making aesthetic changes and, you know, lining things up. You could still use all the functionality of the sketch skin. And in the next section, we have a little bonus here just to sort of think about how we might take this web app design and present it in a smartphone. So we'll see you in the next section to talk about that.